Good afternoon, guys. Another beautiful day, sunny outside. It's up to 22 now. It was -1 this morning with a real feel of -9. So I have not been out of the shop today, but now that it's warming up, it's time to prep the saws and get out there. I have my DeWalt battery powered, have the borrowed Husqvarna, got to sharpen that because I was running dull last time, and got a new chain to put on the DeWalt because I don't remember if I showed you guys before, but some of these linkage are like busted on one side. That's why I stopped using this for a while. You know, it's kind of sad because there's like so much tooth left, but I was not about ready to have that thing snap and wrap around my hand. It's not worth that. So we'll start by changing this chain out. This chain is a lot less stretched out than the old one. I had to turn it way back. Nice. That's ready to go. We'll take this Husky Red up here and lock it in the vise and get it sharpened. Yeah, keep the vise nice in the middle of the bar so you don't tweak the track if the chain runs through, you know? This chain is nice. It has some of those little angle lines that I was telling you about a while back. So you can see the angle you want to file at. I definitely prefer hand sharpening my saws. You know, there's been a few times where I've been around places that have the electric sharpeners, and I just do not like the result as much. Back to our double teeth. It's good right there. Well, the neighbor just got the sawmill wired up. It's kind of rigged. Anyway, I'm out here to see it run for the first time. He's already cut a couple logs on it, but
so it's a beautiful sunny day up, and we started out at what, maybe 12 below zero at the end of February. And boy, it's warmed up wonderfully. I don't even know how warm it is, but it's wonderful. And we've got a beautiful sun. So today our goal was, we bought a sawmill, and the sawmill runs off of three-phase electric power. So we bought this Army surplus three-phase generator, and I'm going to start it up for you here. So first we turn on the panel light switch, and then we turn on the master control switch. And there's one thing you want to remember there is to always turn those off after you've shut the machine down. Otherwise, you'll be charging batteries. So this is a 24-volt starting system. Panel switch on, master control switch on, and then I turn our engine control all the way over to prime run. And our network failure light comes on. That's a nice little red light there. And we'll wait for that light to go off. When that light goes off, as it did, that means it's ready to start. I'm going to hold the fault reset switch up or on while I'm starting it. Then I drop the switch off, and we let it idle for a little bit to warm up. Now today we've run it already, so it won't take long. My next step will be to energize the three-phase terminals coming out, and I do that by turning this one more time to the right and releasing it. Then if you look really closely on our screen, it's hard in the sunshine, you see we've got voltage across three different legs, and that should be reading somewhere in the area, they're reading 420, so I'm going to use the voltage adjust switch. And just a couple of volts at a time, I'm going to switch it up and try to get around 440 on each of those legs. So we're right there now, 440, 41, 42. We then have a little category here
that lets us know when we've energized the terminals. We don't have power to the terminals yet. So what I'm going to do over here is take the AC circuit interrupt, and I'm going to close that. And on our screen now, it shows closed. That means we have got power in that cord, and we've got power up to the sawmill. Watch yourself, Joe. Yeah. So we had some issues in our three-phase box up here, which converts three-phase to 24 volts to run our controls, and we couldn't get that figured out. So I've run directly from the 24-volt batteries to my controls. And what we'll do is come over here now and start the motor. It's a 30 horsepower three-phase motor. We'll start that, and automatically then our hydraulic pump will start to be actuated. So up here on the panel, we have an on-off switch. I'm going to flip it on.
So that now just automatically advances like that when you turn it on?
Every single time you turn it on or do certain functions, it reverses about 6 inches. Not sure why that design is, but there's a reason for it. It shakes you up a little bit at first, but it'll all just stop.
Nice.
So we got our mill running. Now over here, I power my 24 volts on, and that gives me all my controls and my hydraulics now. So our first step is we're going to load a log, and I'll raise our backstop. Come over here, we'll go ahead and activate the blade. Now we've got the blade spinning. So I don't remember where I was on that measurement, so I'll have to bring it back and see if we can get close. So my measurement right here is a little over 12. So we'll come on back now. And since I was at 12, I'm going to drop down about 2 inches. And see if I can't get a 2-inch board, maybe. so I can get a 2x6. It's a little strong, about 2 1/8. Bring that off here like that. That'll go to our edger later on.
Nice.
So that's kind of nice. That'll make a nice clean 2x6. So again, I did not check my measurement, so I'm going to have to go back and figure out what that is carefully so we don't damage the blade. That's pretty close there. We're going to come back. I'm at about right at 12 again. I'm going to drop a little lower than 10. About right in there is where I want to be. I came real close to my backstop there. Uncomfortably close. I'd like an 8-inch. I don't know if I can get an 8-inch, but I'm 8 there. We can see. So I'll go a little higher, and that way if my 8 doesn't work out, I can still cut a 6-inch and get rid of the curve. Oh, we were blessed on that one. I can probably flip that log right at 8 inches and get my 6 inches going the other way. Thank you. we're going to do this. We'll clean this one up by hand because I got carried away with my hydraulics. Okay, we're locked in there. Don't really know where I'm going to be at yet. I've got 8 inches wide. I can go down to 6. So probably I'll start up here at 6, go to 8 1/4, 8 1/8. That's about all we're going to get out of it. But we can still get a good 2x8 out of there, it looks like. 2x8 pay well. Okay, so we're going to drop down now to a 6 and an 8 roughly. We'll get a good 2x8, ideally a 6x8, but that 6x8 looks kind of messy. Shut our blade off a little bit. Now you can see this board here. You never know with cedar till you get in it. We had a beautiful 2x8 on this side. And flip it over, we're in the rot, and that means our 6x8's bad too.
Wow.
Now these weigh about 100 pounds a piece on the average. Some much lighter, some much heavier. On the average, when they're sawed out, a 6x8 is going to be about 100 pounds.
When they plane that into a log cabin log, it might clean up some of that rot. But they won't like to see too many of those come in a batch. Get my pickeroon. We'll use that to drag logs around a little bit. Now this one's got a real belly in it. And it's also got some rot in the center, so I don't know how this one will saw out, but you never know until you get into them.
Back here at the swamp again. Just counting the days. Pretty soon won't be able to come back here. This is warming up. It's fun being over there seeing the neighbor's mill run for the first time. Anyway, being back, I'm thinking I've got a nice maple trunk here, two back there. And then back in there another 100 feet, 75 feet. We have a lot of trees down. So I'm gonna try and get these ones right now and then see about cutting the small stubs, because, you know, getting us trail back there, because last thing we need is pop a tire. Yeah. Boy, does that new blade ever cut good. Look at these nice big chips. Oh yeah, getting that all over the four-wheeler. That was intelligent. Oh, that's a, oh, that's gorgeous. Gorgeous maple trunk right there. So I'm thinking if I can get like 3 firewood length logs, just heap them up here and cut them out there later, you know? Gotta take it real easy when you're dealing with heavy stuff like this. Because if you don't, man, you can do some damage fast. There we go. See, I'm not sure the best direction to pick for a trail. So we got these stobs everywhere. Man, you can't really tell in the snow what's under it, you know? If I go for that more open area, it's probably a waterway I could easily fall into. got that one down. Moving back here to this pile. I mean, look at this selection. Little one right there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wow. Oh, 5. And that's just right in this miniature section. Now that log right there, I showed you before, that's a hefty one. I'll have to get close by for that. I'm thinking we'll clean this little one up, some of the top of that one, you know. Good little section there. 5 lengths of wood. We'll see how this does. I dare say we're gonna get the biggest load on here I've had so far. It's already. Well, there we go. Definitely the biggest load. Let's see if we can get out of here with it. decided I'll just pile these right on the bank here. And we want to get around to working them up. They'll be right there to stack. And I don't think we're going to have any more snow to speak of this year. So it's not like I'm going to be back here plowing again. That was a nice little jag of wood. Thanks for joining me again. Remember, keep tinkering. I'll just pile these right on the bank here, and we want to get around to working them up. They'll be right there to stack, and I don't think we're going to have any more snow to speak of this year, so it's not like I'm going to be back here plowing again. That was a nice little jag of wood. Thanks for joining me again. Remember, keep tinkering.